started with a sickly boy who grew into one of the greatest naval strategists. I am Lord Horatio Viscount Nelson. My career was filled with difficult decisions. I was ostracized by my peers and politicians. I had many health problems, but in my career, I grew in my tactical knowledge and kindness towards my crew. Thanks to my strategy, courageous attitude, and loyalty to Great Britain, I was able. My final hours was spent destroying Napoleon's navy. On the cold morning of September 29, 1758, I was born. I lived with my large family in Norfolk, England, where my father was erected for the Anglican Church. At the age of 12, I set off to join the Navy. With the help of my uncle, Captain Maurice Fancy Pants Suckling, my uncle helped me by sending me to multiple ships to serve, including a merchant ship where I learned how to sail off the rocky coast of England. Suckling was rarely present, but this neglect led me to be one of the kindest captains in the British Navy. In April 8, 1777, I headed to the East Indies to start my great naval career. Later in 1779, I was made post-captain and was sent to the British West Indies. Even though I had proven myself to be a tactical genius in several battles, the merchants in the West Indies hated me. I kept laws they wanted to break. While there, I met and married Francis Nesbitt. I had made too many enemies. I was sent home to England, where I would spend the next 5 years in exile on 25 cents a day. Later, I was brought back when Napoleon and England went to war in 1798. In 1805, Napoleon seized most of Europe, but England and her navy stood in his way of total world dominance. After many captains had failed to destroy Napoleon, I was made captain of the British fleet in the Mediterranean. My flagship, the Victory, had been through several small battles, but with no final success. This all changed at the Battle of Trafalgar. I had lost my right arm and my right eye, but I was determined not to lose to Napoleon. At the Battle of Trafalgar, I made my final stand with a new strategy. I was able to destroy Napoleon's navy before I was shot through the spine. I lived long enough to hear that it had been a Britain had won. Satisfied with the victory, my final words were, "Thank God I have done my duty." I was one of the greatest seamen to ever sail in the British Navy. Even though my health was never quite well, I worked my way up to commander of the Mediterranean fleet. I dealt with persecution from politicians or other officers, but I never gave up my love of the sea or Great Britain. My career ended with a bullet, but I was able to stop Napoleon's reign of terror. Thank you.